Hey, what's up guys? Landon here, and the update finally came out. So today we're just going to go over all the new update features, what's cool about this update, and what we kind of are hoping for in the next one. And guys, I do want to apologize for no videos for the last couple days. I kept wanting to do the next video to be an update video because I did a bunch of previews, but then the update just didn't come out, so I kind of got lost with that. But to make up for that, I'm going to have two videos today, this first one, and then next is going to be an all new troop maxed out raid, so that's going to be really fun. So if you want to check that out, it'll be in the description down below, and it'll probably be uploaded about 30 minutes after this one goes live. So hopefully you guys check both these out and smack that like button. Alright, so let's go over all of the new update features and all of the hidden features as well, because you guys probably know the big things, but there's some really cool little things that are some really nice tweaks. Alright, so first off, we got the Archer Tower level 13. It looks pretty nice. Got that nice little gold flare with the red shield. You can compare it to the level 12 one. I think it looks a lot nicer. It kind of veers away from the level 9 wall to more of a level 10 wall. So that's a pretty nice upgrade. I like the new Archer Tower, and they also decreased the price of the level 11 and the level 12 Archer Tower. So it reduced, the level 11 went from 5 million to 4.5 million, and the level 12 went from 7.5 to 6.5. So I already had all my Archer Towers up to level 12, which is a bit of a bummer because they got, you know, 1 million decrease in price. So if you haven't got those level 12 ones yet, you're in luck because they're gonna be quite cheaper. Number two, we got a new level Dark Barracks. Boom, level 6, and with that, we got the new troop, of course, the Lava Hound. He looks pretty cool, and he targets the air defenses first. So, the video that's going to be in the description down below is going to be an all max level Lava Hound raid. So that's going to be a lot of fun. Another big part of this update is there are new troops to upgrade. Ooh, we got the Barbarian to level 7, and the Archer to level 7 as well. So the Archer doesn't have a giant boost, but the Barbarian has a pretty significant, I mean, plus 4. I'm really excited to see some of this new barching because everyone is just raving about how great the barching strategy is for farming, and just you can get so much loot for such a cheap cost. So maybe these level 7 tier 1 troops are really going to help people in the Champions League start barching and just destroy some big bases and get some mega loot. So with that, the Lava Hound to level 2, let's just pop this upgrade up. And that's going to be 60,000 in 10 days. We'll gem that up in a bit just to check out the Lava Hounds. So now we're going to kind of cover some of the secret, just kind of the secret hidden features that are really cool. My favorite tweak for this update is, ooh, we got another level 3 Lava Hound. Awesome, we'll have fun with that one. Is the Archer Queen and King, the hero's regen time was significantly decreased. So before, I have level 30 heroes, and when I used them and they died, that's a 2-hour regen wait. So I had to wait two hours, which it's a long time and it sucks. So they significantly reduced the time. So I'd really love to see how long it takes for you guys, for your king and queen level to regen now, because I'm not sure the exact numbers, but I know they are significantly reduced. Another really cool thing, the Valkyrie time. It's been reduced to 8 minutes, which that's pretty nice considering I think it was 15 minutes before. Yep, 15 minutes to 8 minutes, so that's really, really nice. Alright, so the Dark Troops got a little bit of a rebuff. One thing that's really, really cool that I love is the replays got a lot of love. I just got attacked on really nice 2-star maxed heroes. So the replays looks a little different. First off, you can see the troops available. You can fast forward, and then look at this. You can pause. This is going to be super, super great for videos, especially just talking strategy. And we can even do that right now. He just does a go wipe with a few witches, breaks through the base, sends the golems out. Heroes are behind it, got the P.E.K.K.A.s, the wizards are in a nice wave, and it's just a really well-done raid. I love the pause button because it just enables replayers to just show the raid step-by-step and to just really talk about strategy. So I'm really liking the replay upgrade, and I do like the troop available sector. It just cleaned up the replays quite a bit, and it looks a lot nicer. So that is another kind of smaller feature. Another really cool thing is the spell factory got buffed quite a bit. So you know when you misclicked a spell and you wanted to get rid of it, you only got half of the elixir back? They got rid of that, so no more annoying misclick spell raging. You can misclick, then you can unclick, and you get all of your elixir back, so that'll be fun. And also, spells are now created by the same order as they are selected. So, I don't know why they didn't do that before, but I'm glad they fixed the spell factory a little bit. So, they did make that. One really, really cool thing, let's go to my clan castle. Huh. I don't want my balloon. Now we can remove the troop. How cool is that? Remove troops, okay. Boom. No more balloon, just the lava hound. But you can also do that with your army camps. So, let me just train up a few. We'll just train up one barbarian. We're gonna click the army camps, and look, now the red plus button. Okay, boom. Super, super nice when you mistrain some troops, and you don't want to have to go to the campaign map or drop them off or lose trophies or whatever. It's just a really easy way, and it just kind of, it's a nice tweak. Onto this update, there were some big things in this update, but there was a lot of like little fixes that need to touch it up. Like the regen time with the heroes, the lowering time of the Valkyries, just a lot of really nice things. So I really like this update, and there's still quite a bit to go. So now the healers, they really fixed up the healer AI, because if you've been using healers, a lot of the times they just kind of went all over the place, healed some really kind of odd troops that didn't really need it. So now the healers stick to healing bigger groups of troops. So that's super handy if you want to do like a big giant wizard raid or something like that. So hopefully your healers will stick on the majority, the larger parties of your giants, and it'll help your raid overall. So that's going to be really helpful. And it's not, because I always thought the healer AI was just so, so bad. So they're really going to buff that. All right. One really cool thing is a lot of people thought the Lava Hound was going to be Town Hall 10. Lava Hound's Town Hall 9. But for level 2 and 3, you have to have Town Hall 10. So they go up to 3. Level 2 Hounds, you guys saw, the cost is 60,000 Dark Elixir. And getting them up to level 3 is only 70,000. So it's not too bad. I'm excited to use them. If you guys want to check it out, make sure to hit that video in the description down below. Because we're going to do a all Lava Hound raid, and we're also going to play with them a little bit as well. Another cool thing that I've heard super, super, that people are really excited about, you can now upgrade walls with elixir as long as they're level 6 and up. So a lot of people, especially the lower town hall level like 7 or 8, run out of gold super fast and just have these boundless amounts of elixir and can't spend anything with them. That is no longer the case. You can upgrade your walls with elixir, which is really going to bounce out kind of the loot. So people don't have to only focus on getting gold. They can really bounce it out and get gold and elixir and use both of them. So I think that's going to wrap up this episode, guys. I hope you enjoyed. If you did, make sure to smack that like button and tell me what your favorite part of this update was. So guys, Lava Hound gameplay coming out really soon. Hope you guys will check that out. See you next time. Peace, guys. Bye-bye. We'll be right back.